In this video, we'll create a multi-layered animation. To start out, create a new HTML5 canvas. Next, we're going to create a symbol. Go to Insert, New Symbol. This is going to be an animation of a monster, so we'll name it Monster. For type, we'll go with movie clip. Click OK. And now we are inside the symbol we just created. I know that because the entire stage turned white, and when I look up here, it says monster. So we're going to draw a monster inside this monster symbol. And to make animation easier, we're going to do it on multiple layers. Symbols have their own separate timeline, which means that we can create layers inside the symbol. So to start out, we have layer 1. I'm going to draw the monster's body on this layer. So let's double click to rename it Body. Then I'll go over and grab the paintbrush tool and draw a kind of squiggly, blobby body for the monster. The little cross marks the center, so I'll be sure to keep that in mind when I draw. Now I want to fill the body with a color, so let's go select a color. And then I'll use the paint bucket tool to fill in the shape I just created. So now we've got the body done. Next, I want some eyes. Let's create a separate layer for those. And we'll name it Eyes. Then I'm going to grab the oval tool and I want white eyes with a black border around them. So I'll set the stroke color to black and the fill color to white. Make sure the eyes layer is selected. Then click and drag to create the eyeballs. Since these eyeballs are on a separate layer, you can move them if you don't like the position. Next, we need some pupils for the eyes, and we're going to end up animating those pupils, so let's create one more layer. We'll call it pupils. Then I will select the oval tool again. This time I want a black fill and no stroke. Make sure your pupil layer is selected, and then click and drag to create a pupil. I need one for the other eye. And I want it to be the exact same size as the one I already created. So I'm going to select the pupil and then copy and paste. And then I'll use the selection tool to move it to where I want. So we've got a basic monster. Now let's animate the pupils. Before we do that, we're going to turn off snapping. If we leave it on, it's actually harder to get the pupils exactly where we want them. Go to View, Snapping, and then we'll turn off Snap Align, and Snap to Objects. Now we can move the pupils to whatever position we want. I'll start them out on the left. Next, let's go to our timeline and click on frame 25 in the pupil layer. Then press F6 to create a keyframe. So we get a keyframe, and there are the pupils, but the rest of the monster disappeared. Why is that? Well, the rest of the monster does not exist on frame 25, so we need to fix that. Now, we could create a keyframe on each of these other layers. But we really only want to use keyframes when something changes. The body and the eyeballs are not going to change, so instead, I'll press F5. This extends the layer to frame 25 without actually adding a keyframe. So now we're ready to animate. Select the keyframe on frame 25, and then we'll move the pupils to the right. And then, to smooth things out, we'll right-click somewhere between the two keyframes and create shape tween. And now the monster's pupils will move smoothly from the left to the right. Let's now get out of our symbol and go to scene 1. When we switch back to scene 1, notice that the timeline is empty. That's because all the animation we've done so far is inside the symbol on the monster's timeline. So now I can drag the symbol from the library to the stage. And let's make the monster move across the stage. We'll start him on the left, and then we'll go to, say, frame 80. Select it, and then press F6 to create a keyframe. And now we'll move the monster to the right. And finally, we'll add a tween. When we animated the pupils, we used a shape tween. That's because the pupils are a drawing that we created. But now that we're back out in scene 1, the monster is a symbol. And to animate a symbol, we can use either motion tweens or classic tweens. This time I'll use a classic tween. Let's test it. Control test. And now we have a monster that moves across the stage while the pupils of his eyes also move.